Hello, welcome. This is Accounting with Bennett Tchaikovsky. Our topic today is going to be non-current liabilities or bonds, and we're going to be recording interest expense using the effective interest method for the premium or discount. This presentation is copyright 2008 to 2018 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. All rights are reserved. So it's kind of a recap. We were looking before at the straight line method of amortizing the discount or the premium. And in that one, the focus was just on that premium, that amortization of that premium or discount. The interest expense is always the same and it's kind of backed into. And, you know, that whole method is really, the numbers are never going to change. Every single time when you're paying cash for interest, your entry is always going to be the same. The real question becomes, is that really the most accurate method in terms of recording interest expense when it comes to a bond? And the answer is no. However, I would kind of caveat that is how material is the amount? Is it a significant amount? But at the end of the day, the effective interest method is by far the better and more preferred method because you're really taking that carrying value of that bond and you are going through and calculating interest based on what it's being carried at on your books valuation, on your balance sheet for every period. And again, the goal is for the effective interest method and the straight line method is that we ultimately want to take those premiums and discounts down to zero so that upon maturity, our balance sheet will just be showing the bond at its face value when it's actually due. But we're just getting there in two different ways. So what's common to both methods is that one is that the journal entry to record interest expense isn't changing for either method. We're still going through and using this for premiums. We're going through here and we're using this for discounts. And I want to encourage you to go back to the other videos to kind of see how this works. Also, the cash paid for interest is also not going to change from the prior method that we were doing. When we're doing straight line amortization, we would figure out cash, we'd figure out the premium amortization, we back in it interest expense. Here we're going to be focusing on our interest expense first. So let's go through an example. Here we've got YYZ issues bonds with a face value of $10 million. The bonds pay interest annually. Stated rate is 8%, market rate is 10, and the term of the bonds is 10 years. The first step I'm going to go through and do is I'm going to compute the present value of the bond. And so what that's going to be is basically right here, determine the entry to record interest expense using the effective interest method. And the first thing I'm going to go through and do is what are the bond proceeds going to be? Again, I want to encourage you, if this seems like you need review on this, go back to the other videos. Right here, I've got $10 million, which is the amount of the principal. The present value of 10 periods at 10% is 0.38554. Here, I've got the interest at $800,000. Present value of an annuity, 10 periods at 10%. 6.14457. So my total cash proceeds are going to be the sum of these two amounts, or $8,771.56. So when it comes to doing the journal entry, right, I've got here a discount on bonds payable of $1,228,944. So I need to ultimately get this down to zero. So how is this going to work? Well, the way we're going to do it and the way we use to record interest using the effective interest method is I'm going to start here with my carrying value. And what is my carrying value? It's really what I'm showing on my balance sheet, which is going to be my bonds payable less the discount on bonds payable gives me bonds payable net. Or here, this will be $10 million less the amount of the discount, or, and this is going to be as of 1/1/19. So my carrying value right over here on January 1st, 2019 is going to be $8,771.56. Now, what I do to figure out my interest expense is I'm going to take my market interest rate of 10%. So I'm going to take this here, 10%. And when I multiply the carrying value by the interest rate, that's going to be giving me my interest expense. So again, the interest is not being based on the straight line amortization. It's being based on what is the carrying value. And I'm going to be comparing this to my cash payment. My cash payment was 10 million times 8%, or the stated amount of the interest rate times the face value of the bond, or 800,000. So the amount I'm going to be amortizing that discount for is going to be the difference between the interest expense and the straight line amortization. So my ending carrying value is going to be $8,771.56 plus $77,106, or $8,848.162. And if I just kind of, if I go back and remember that when I'm doing the intro, the journal entry, why am I adding this back? And it's because ultimately this is essentially, we want this number to get bigger and bigger. We want this discount to ultimately go to zero. So my carrying value is going to be gradually be increasing, because I ultimately are going to take this to zero. So my carrying value, I ultimately want to be this to be at 10 million. So that's going to be for the first year. And so for 2020, what we're going to do is our ending becomes our beginning. The interest rate doesn't change. Interest expense, same equation, $8,848.162. My cash isn't changing either. And so my discount amortization here is going to be $84,816. My ending carrying value is going to be my beginning carrying value plus the amount of the amortized discount, or for a total of $8,932,978. This question here was asking me for what was the interest expense for the year ended December 31st, 2021. So what I'll need to do is to go here and to figure out this part is essentially, I take this here, I go down again, and basically repeat the same functions. I'm just going through each year. I'm gradually taking this discount on bonds payable, which was 1/1/19. And then what I'm doing is every single year, I'm going through and amortizing that discount. And ultimately, I'm going to essentially write this off down to zero. But let's just kind of do it for fun. Because what should my ending carrying value be? What have I said it should be? It should be around 10 million bucks. And so if I go through here and I carry this through, I get to almost 10 million. Now I'm off because more than likely there was a rounding issue, but I'm pretty close. So let's go through and answer our question. It was asking us for the amount, the journal entry for the year ended December 31st, 2021. Here, my interest expense is going to be $893,298. My discount on bonds payable is going to be $93,298. And my interest expense never changes because, my cash, wow, Tchaikovsky, good job. My cash is going to be $800,000. And that part here won't change as we're going through and doing these problems. So that's our first part here when we have a discount situation. Now, what if we had a premium situation? Well, the premium is going to be a little bit different because in that case here, what I'm doing is I've got a higher carrying value, but I need to make it lower. So let's see how that one works. So on January 1st, 2019, I issue bonds with a face value of 15 million. The bonds pay interest annually, stated is 9, market is 8. So I know it's going to be issued at a premium. And again, I want to encourage you that if you are lost, like on an island with Kate and Jack and Hurley, What I want you to do is go back to my other videos. And this here, I actually, believe it or not, I did actually change this. This is 8 periods at 8%. It's just, we're getting close to the witching hour or something else like that. So this is 8 periods at 8%. Sorry about that. And so my total present value of my proceeds is going to be $15,862.14. And again, this is a premium situation. Why? Stated rate is higher than market. My proceeds will be greater than my will be greater than the face value of the bond. So I have this premium here on January 1st, 2019 for $862.14. I need to get this down to zero and let's see how this works. So my carrying value initially is going to be, essentially it's the premium on bonds payable plus the bonds payable are $15,862.14. My market rate of interest is 8%. And so my interest expense is going to be the $15,862.14 times the 8%. Now, when I look at the amount of the cash payment for interest, my actual interest that's being paid is $1,350,000. And that amount will never, ever change. And so what ends up happening, what's a little bit different about our journal entry here for the premium situation is I'm going to have to be essentially my amortization. I need this to eventually go down. Why? Because when I look at my carrying value on January 1st, 2019, if I have my bonds payable here plus my premium of $862.14, my bonds payable net is here. When I get to the end of that first year, I need this number to go down. So I need my carrying value to be decreasing over time. So my amortization is going to be the cash minus the interest expense, but my ending carrying value, and this is different than what we were doing on the discount on bonds payable, is going to be my beginning less my premium amortization, or $1,780,975. And if we went through and took this all the way through, and hopefully this will work because I didn't actually go through and test this, I would hate to have to make yet another video. So let's just go see if we get this thing to work. And let's see if the magic happens. Yay, getting down here to 15 million, the little things that excite us. Okay, so what's happening here is every single year is that what's different about the premium is that I've got to be taking this down because my goal is by say 12/31, I don't know, like what was this year over here? 12/31/26. I want this premium to be zero. So what I see is what's actually happening is that the interest expense is actually decreasing over time, but it's because because the carrying value is decreasing. So this is what I'm going through and doing. And what is it asking me for here? It's asking me for the interest expense to refer December 31st, 2021. So this is what I'm doing right here. And so my debit to interest expense will be for $1,255,476. My premium will be amortized by $94,524. My cash will be for $1,350,000. And so this will be the journal entry I'm going to use. Of course, I would need to be showing here. Let's make this a little bit nicer. Let me maybe let's get rid of those highlights. Okay, so I got debit, credit, account. So right here again, what I'm doing is I've got to bring this carrying value down. I need to bring it down to 15 million. So the way I'm going to be doing it is obviously my interest expense will be lower than the cash payment. And if you kind of remember going back to that whole portion of the straight line amortization, I was generally deducting the premium amortization from the cash payment to get to my interest expense. So that's what the thought is there. But I want to recommend to you as you're going through and you're practicing effective interest problems to write out the chart and make it get down to zero, because this is really the key for your understanding of this effective interest method. Thank you so much today for joining me, and I will see you soon on the next accounting video. Make sure to like and subscribe. Thank you so much.